Oh, welcome back. It is Saturday morning here at Urban. I have got some deficit deadlifts today. I'm going to see about doing some bench. I'm going to see how the body feels. I did just bench last night. So might just call it at the deficit deadlifts and some safety bar good mornings today. And just sometimes got to listen to the body. We're not trying to push ourselves to the point beyond recovery. But the gym has been like peak vibes all morning. I kind of wish I'd taken the camera out a little bit earlier, I'm not going to lie. Some incredible kind of like great atmosphere around the place. But we got Sarah in, who's prepping for Junior Euros, who's actually competing this time next weekend. TJ's just come down, get some rap squats with him. Maeve just put in a killer performance on squats, massive AMRAP, 132 for 12 reps. We got Lizzo in with some crazy ass looking hair. Check this shit out.
That's
like something like a Brady bunch, right? Anyway, I'm gonna get myself warmed up to deficit deads. Sarah's gonna take 115. We got Kerry in as well this morning. She just got a ticket for abs 15, which is sick. We got a serious crew coming up for it. So yeah, Shawnee, Kyron, everybody's been training this morning. It's been, like I said, it was peak. I should have got the camera out earlier, but we learn.
Now, there you go. That's lightweight for you. Squat. Big air. Through the wraps. Through the wraps. Take it off.
And easy.
Back. Go.
My bad.
Go.
Easy.
Now, wrap.
I'm a little gangster.
I put my city on the map, but let me tell you about it. Hey, Charlie. Yeah. Life.
Fresh.
Life is on.
Finish it, finish it, finish it.
They need me to go.
Oh yeah, I did. That was a whole hip thrust. Keep it against you, accelerate, accelerate, finish it, finish it, finish it, finish it, finish it. Down.
Act like your son. We gonna praise our way out the grave, dog. Living, speaking, praise. Out the grave, dog. Back to life. I serve you. Follow your word. See what you're like. Until the night. Still outside, still outside. Not touching, still outside, still outside. Tim, Tim,
still
outside. Still outside, still outside.
Well, that was fucking shit. oh, I'm being dramatic. In all honesty, that was not my favorite session yet. Really not that pleased. I'm really just not that pleased with how I performed, how I selected the weights. I think I maybe let some ego get in the way there. I don't even know if it was intentional, I think. I mean, like, I was here until just after 9 p.m. last night. And then I was up again at about 6:30 this morning. I didn't go to bed until like after 11:30. So my body was wrecked. Like, I'm tired, I'm under recovered. And I'd only just safety bar squatted, which I find is very like low back dominant for me. Not dominant, but I can feel it like a lot in the low back area. I get like a pump in the low back area from that variation, which is fine. It's very similar to low bar. But you know, that's just where I tend to feel some fatigue from that variation. And then I came in today and I had deficit deadlifts and my positioning was all off. It was all over the place. I felt kind of rushed. And I normally don't train that early. Like, I normally train at 5 p.m. This is like 10 a.m. So, not... yeah. Multiple variables as to why that may have not gone the way I wanted it to. 270 and 300 for a single, then 280 for a triple. Felt like a bit of a strain across the low back. Not a bad one, just one of those things of like, oh, you pushed too far today. So I've just left it there. So I'm feeling a bit deflated after it. I just feel like I kind of didn't put my best foot forward. My intentions were good, but just didn't execute well. And that happens. I got so fixated on like hitting 300. I wasn't fixated per se, but that was the goal for the day. And then I just kind of lost sight of anything else. It happens. But it's amateur stuff, you know, that's a rookie mistake and I'm really not pleased about it. But the gym was lit. Everybody was having a great time. I caught some of other people's lifts. And again, the stuff that happened way earlier this morning was like super fun as well, with Kai and Sean deadlifting. And you had Maeve bodying some squats. Like, it was a good morning. Thoroughly enjoyable, actually. And then I just ruined my own day with the shitty ass performance. And that's the thing, like, it's within my control. I could have pulled back, and I didn't. Just told me, you're just off groove, you just need to clean it up. They're like, nah, bro, you need to take some weight off the bar today. Oh, well. We live and we learn. We live to lift another day. I probably won't do this all as one video. It's on its own. This will probably be a two-part video where I'll include Monday on this. Ugh. So frustrating, but... what are you going to do? I'll check in with you guys Monday. It is now Monday, October 9th. It's just gone 5 o'clock, which means that it is time to squat. Plan for today is to work up somewhere between 275 and 310. Last week, you would have seen that I worked up to 295 for a triple. Back to single this week. On the second rep of the 295, I had a bit of a pop in my elbow. It's been aggravated ever since. So I'm gonna spend a little bit more time kind of warming up the area, getting in, getting some behind the neck lat pull downs in, get some band work in, just kind of get some blood flow into the area, see if I can open it out, stretch it open. And we're gonna see what happens when we get in under the bar. Look, fingers crossed, I'm not like totally confident that I'm gonna be able to hold onto the bar. And I really don't wanna aggravate it and make it worse, but we have to get the squats in. So we're gonna take it as it comes, kind of build up towards it and see what happens. I feel strong, I'm confident in my ability to squat. The elbow is definitely giving me some concern. It's uncomfortable at the best of times without it being aggravated. Now it feels really uncomfortable just kind of existing. So this is all just part of the process. It's part of the game sometimes. We just gotta get through it. So let's get warmed up, let's go squat. I just couldn't give in to the pain. I just kept telling myself, reaffirming that it's just pain, it's just pain. Like, pain can create a lot of apprehension and fear around certain things, and it's one of those things that can just get in your way a lot. Like, pain within reason, like, it's just uncomfortable. You know what I mean? I'm not gonna die, I'm not gonna get any worse. You know, I just brought the uprights on the mono in a little bit. I brought them right into the edge. So I had like slightly more grip width, but not excessive amounts where the bar wobbled. And I just knew I took 220, 275, or 225, 275, and then straight to 310. And very, very pleased with how that moved. Just got the back offsets to go on now, some triples. First set is with 285. Probably drop the weight back after that. I think Noli's going to wrap me for this set, and then I'm going to self-wrap after that. So, yeah, happy. Moved better than 305 than 2 weeks ago. So I think it was the right call to kind of take the singles in waves and do singles every other week rather than every week. So I just kind of build momentum session to session. Pleased, very pleased. All right, back to squat. Okay, so that is tonight's session wrapped. Overall, very pleased with it. I just wrapped up my accessories there. I didn't bother filming them. You saw them in the last session. Like, accessories are fine. They're quite repetitive. We're just probably a bit boring to film every time, to be honest. But if you want to see more accessories, let me know. I'll keep them in, but they don't really change. Well, unless it's an off season, but right now it's minimum effective dose of the accessories. So if you want to see more, I'm happy to leave them there. Let me know in the comments. But yeah, I'm happy out. 310 kilo single on the squat. Moved better than 305 to 2 weeks ago. You know, elbow is, it is what it is. Just got to keep working through it. Happy with the execution overall, though. Saw the triples for back offs, especially the 280 for the top triple. Very, very pleased with that. Moved significantly better than 295 last week as well. Sure, it was 15 kilos lighter, but that was, you know, after taking 310. I'm very, very pleased with how it moved, and just gradually reduced the weight down and descended down for the other sets and self wrapped. Then just moved into my accessories. I've decided that for the next couple of weeks, I'm not going to be benching post squats because it is aggravating the elbow. And then I end up with a shit ton of bicep tendonitis and stuff. So I'm just focusing on the squat session, and my accessories are on the squats for afterwards. I'm not, and I'm going to introduce an additional training day. So I'm going to train tomorrow. Typically we take Tuesdays off at the moment, but tomorrow I will do my bench and some upper accessories that I would typically have, and then Wednesday will be deadlifts, and then Thursday I have to squeeze my safety bar pauses and my deficit deadlifts into the one session, because then I go to Budapest to see Sarah compete in Junior Euros on Friday. So, well, she's competing Saturday, but I fly out Friday, and I'm only bringing a small bag, so I'm bringing like my full training kit. But yeah, just happy to have like redeemed where I was at from the last session on Saturday. So I've included that at the beginning of the video. You would have seen like from Saturday, I was like really not too pleased with how that deadlift session went. So I feel like I've redeemed that today, and I've come back better than last time. And yeah, I'll probably include tomorrow's bench, so you'll get the deficit deadlifts, squats, and then bench on this video. and then Wednesday will be a separate video on its own. So, all right, that is it. I'll check back in with you guys for bench tomorrow. All right, we're back again. It is now Tuesday. So, it's just gone about 6 p.m. So I just have bench and some accessories today. Last night, we worked up to some pretty heavy squats. Definitely a little bit beat today, but I still gotta get that bench in. I am under some time pressure this week because I fly out to Budapest on Friday. So I just have today, Wednesday, tomorrow I'll be deadlifting, and then Thursday I'll have to double up on my safety bar pause squats and my deficit deadlifts. Not crazy about deadlifting 2 days in a row. Honestly, for the most part, I'm not really crazy about squatting the day after deadlifting, but we just taper the numbers back and make sure we stay in a nice groove, we're staying in the pocket, we're not overshooting anything, and that we're taking all that fatigue into account. So now I'm gonna go out, hit my comp bench, we have a top single. We're gonna see how everything is kind of moving, and I'm not gonna like closely attach to too many numbers, just gonna get warmed up, go through the usual warm-ups, hit 150, then maybe 170, and then make a call after that. Last week, hit 185, that moved really, really well, so who knows? Might be a little more than that this week, might be a little bit less. Either way, we're gonna get the work done. Let's go. Worked up to relatively handy single at 190. I took 150, then I went to 170, and then 170, 180, 190 all move pretty similarly. So I can't always gauge it just off how 170 moves. So 170, 180, 190, like just made 10 kilo increments, and they all moved kind of the same. They all felt kind of the same as well. So I then had triples with 170. To be honest, my biceps are throbbing after every single set, and the pressure in under the elbow sleeves. The elbow sleeves aren't that tight, they're like a normal fit, and usually they feel fine, but there's obviously just a little bit of extra inflammation in the biceps today that is like super aggravated. That's due to the squats yesterday, realistically. Like, this session is something that I had started working around and putting it in on a Thursday after safety bars, because safety bar squats aren't going to aggravate anything, because I'm obviously holding it from here. but just the way my schedule was lining up this week, with travel at the end of the week, I had to get it in today. I didn't want to push it any further. You know, I don't really massively like benching after I deadlift. And I just have a lot on work-wise over the next few days, that to try and get the bench in first and then to deadlift would have been really eating into that session. I don't want to have to rush the deadlifts. Deadlifts is the main priority for tomorrow. So, yeah, got in two sets at 170. I'm uncomfortable right now around the tendons, around the biceps, and it's just frustrating, but it is just, it's just a feeling, it's just soreness, it's just discomfort. So it is very, very workable. It's not something that concerns me. I know how to work around it. Just moments like today will happen from time to time. So I've got two sets left. I'm gonna drop it back to 120, just grease the groove. Hopefully I don't get as much tension in the biceps from it. The alternative is to just call it a day and, you know, leave it there, but I obviously don't want to do that, do I? So I want to get some work done, and, you know, hopefully be able to come back after I get back from Budapest, have another big squat session next Monday, and get back to bench, like do my comp bench again next Thursday, and kind of assess it from there. But yeah, listen, we still got a couple weeks to go before the comp is up, so I'm really not that concerned about it. It's just so annoying in the moment. It's so distracting. It can be very disheartening at times, but I'm old as shit, man. Like, at least I feel it. But yeah, we get through these sets of 120. This is, realistically, this is child's play at this point. But just grease the groove. A couple of things that I'm working on technique-wise. I'm gripping the bench and how I'm bringing it down. So it's just an opportunity to kind of sharpen the blade a little bit more, and, you know, rather than focusing on what I can't do really well right now, I'm just going to lean into what I can do and what I can do to get a little bit better. So there's always progress to be made somewhere. All right, so that is a wrap on that session. Let's look back at it. So to summarize the last 3 days of training, we had the deficit deadlifts. Upon reflection, not maybe as bad as I initially made it out to be. Then I had a great session yesterday when I hit that 310 in the squat. And then I had today's where I benched 190 and I was tripling 170 really, really comfortably. Yes, I'm aware there's I'm definitely not, I'm complaining a lot. I'm aware I'm complaining a bit. I'm complaining about this is sore, that sore, that's not moving the way I want it to. It's such a cliche thing for powerlifters to do. I mean, I guess a lot of you out there that powerlift could definitely relate to it. It's like, I'm hitting all of the numbers I'm supposed to. My training is continuing to trend up, and yet I still feel like I'm shit or like it's not going good enough. It's a really, really weird thing. It's like some sessions are just going to feel like trash. And I've just had the deficit deadlift session just felt a little bit trashy. It was fine. My groove was off, but I hit all the numbers I was supposed to. I had a little strain across the back, but I knew that that was just something that was going to go away after a day or so. It was just pushing any further that day potentially would have been asking for trouble. Then squats yesterday, fire, very, very pleased with that session. Couldn't have asked for more. Then we come in today, one day later, and I knew this was going to be an issue. It's just the way my schedule worked out. But when I squat, especially on a squat bar, my biceps and elbows get bride. And I've been dealing with this kind of like elbow niggle. So just a lot of like small things. This is part of that journey. For me anyway, it's part of my journey in powerlifting where I'm always a bit beat up. I'm sure a lot of you are. And it's just one of those things you kind of have to go through. And, you know, when I put it all into perspective, actually, it's not so bad. I think I just need to find a way of reframing in the moment when I may be feeling a little bit beat or a little bit, you know, burned out or fatigued in the session, that I'm not becoming like so defeated, even though I'm doing the work I'm supposed to be getting done. You know what I mean? I just need to find a way of like reframing that, managing my expectations session to session a little bit better. You know, I know which sessions I need to come in and I'm like fully amped up and I'm ready to go and I'm aggressive with it. And then there's other sessions where I don't need to be that, you know, amped up all the time. I can just kind of come in, you know, go into cruise control a little bit, get the reps in and just have good quality work. Whereas like sometimes my expectations are just a little bit on the high side every single session. So it's just something I need to maybe work on and work on reframing my mindset when I'm in those moments about what it is I'm actually supposed to achieve that day and not constantly trying to like beat myself into the ground. But hey, that is it for now. I'm signing out of this video. Guys, if you enjoyed the content, if you enjoyed the video, please make sure to give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Tell your mates about it. Share it, please. I mean, I'm not trying to beg, but, you know, share it. I'm definitely trying to grow this channel, definitely trying to grow a larger audience for it and, you know, bring powerlifting to a lot more people. Yeah, drop a comment below. I will see you guys in the next video. Next up, we got deadlifts coming, so I guess that'll be tomorrow. That's it for now. Shinne, peace.